So let us continue working on the solution for this problem statement of getting daily revenue per product and save it into file system. So far we have computed daily revenue per product ID. That is not good enough. We need to get the product name also. Okay. And after we getting the product name, data also have to be sorted in ascending order by order date and in descending order by daily revenue per product. Okay, and we need to get the order date, daily revenue per product, as well as product name. That is the desired final output. But to get the product name, we have to load the products from local file system and convert into RDD, and we have to join with daily revenue per product ID. Now let us understand how to load products from local file system. The location of products in the local file system is data, retail underscore DB, products. Okay, and when we try to read the files from the local file system using Scala IO API, we have to give the file name. It is not enough to give the directory name. We have to read each file separately, update the collection, and if we have to create the RDD, we have to use Parallels to create the RDD. In this case, there is only one file. It's a very small file. So this is the path of that file. In case, if you have to iterate, you have to iterate if there are multiple files. That being said, first thing you need to do is you have to import scala.io.source. Okay. And then you can say products raw, because I'm trying to read the raw data. Source dot from file. If you are not sure about the API, what we can do, we can actually go back to the console and then we can say source dot and hit tab, and you can see what all APIs that are available. From file is one of them. So I can use source dot from file. Give the path. I'm just copy pasting this path. Okay. And then dot get lines. This will actually convert the data in the file into a collection, considering each line in that file as an element in the collection. So get lines will actually use the new line character as delimiter. And each line will be considered as an element in the collection which will be created. And it actually creates iterable or iterator. Let me check what it will create. It creates iterator. Okay. And if you look at Parallels, which will convert a collection into RDD, if you look at the syntax of the Parallels, you see the argument Parallels takes is a sequence type, and iterator is not sequence type. Iterator is parent to sequence. So we cannot actually directly use iterator to convert into RDD. What we need to do, we have to convert the collection which is generated as iterator by using getLines into a sequence type of object, and sequence is a parent class in the Scala collections hierarchy, and one of the collection which falls under sequence is list. So we can convert our iterator to list, and then we can actually pass it to Parallels. So I'm going back to here, and I'm also adding dot to list. So any collection will have the APIs which starts with 2, and you can convert into whatever collection you want, such as list set, etc. In this case, I just need to convert into list. That's why I'm using to list. Now I am creating products RDD by saying sc.parallels products raw. Okay. And let's preview the data also. Products.takeoff10. Dot for each println, and then products dot count. Now let me copy up to here first, and then we will preview and also get the count. You can see the data here. Products is of type list now because I have used to list, and products because I have used parallels to convert list into RDD. Products is RDD, and each element in that RDD is of type string, and we can actually preview the data. And also we can get the count. You can see there are 1345 records. Once we create the RDD, now we have to convert into key value pair so that we can join with our daily revenue per product ID. Okay. So loading products from local file system and convert into RDD is done. Now we have to join daily revenue per product ID with products to get daily revenue per product by name. And if you have to join that, the prerequisite to join two datasets are both the datasets have to be paired RDD, or each element in the RDD has to be key value pair, which is nothing but a tuple. But products is the RDD of type string, so we have to extract it into a, or we have to transform it into a pair or key value tuple. How can we do that? We can use map function, and we need to identify what should be the key and what should be the value. The key is nothing but product ID, and value is nothing but product name, because that's the only information we need. That being said, let us say products map as the variable name and apply the logic on products using map function to transform the string into a tuple. So here I am naming it as product, and the output is RDD of type tuple. Product is of type string, and the return type of this function which we are passing to map has to be of type tuple. That's why I put it in the circular brackets. Now I can see product.split, comma, 0. It is of type integer, so we have to typecast to integer. It's very important to typecast at the right time. And then product.split, comma, let's look into the data to understand where our name is. So this is product ID, this is product category ID, and this is the name. Okay, so as it is third element, I can say 2 here. Okay, now let's preview the data as also. Products map dot take of 10 dot for each println, and then products map dot count. Products count and products map count will be same, but the products map data is paired RDD, whereas products data is RDD of type string. Let me paste these things. You can see here there are 1345 records in this also, and now products map is of type paired RDD. Okay, and if you recollect our daily revenue per product ID and preview the data, so here I am previewing the data of daily revenue per product ID. And if you see, the key for daily revenue per product ID is of type tuple, right? And the value is revenue. But our products map have the product ID as key. Can we join these two? No. If you look at the syntax of join, the key has to be same between the two data sets. Both have to be paired RDDs, and the first element in both the paired RDDs should represent the same business value. In this case, products map have product ID, and daily revenue per product ID has a composite key. So what we have to do, first we have to transform this where we get the product ID as key and move the date to value so that we can join with products. Okay, so we have to add additional transformation here. val daily revenue per product id map equal to rec dot map rec. And what is the rec type? Rec type is order date, order product ID, and then daily revenue per product ID. And what is the desired output? Desired output is order product ID, comma, order date, comma, daily revenue per product ID. We just need to alter the order of these things. Okay, so rec represents this one. To get order product ID, if I say rec dot underscore one, I'll get this tuple. If I say rec dot underscore one, I'll get order date. To get order product ID, I have to say rec dot underscore one dot underscore two. Because our final outcome needs to be tuple, I put it in the circular brackets. And now the value is again a tuple. And we have to get order date. Rec dot underscore one gives the tuple. And again, if we say underscore one, it will give order date. And then rec dot underscore two will get the revenue. So using this logic, the data will be transformed from this format to this format. Okay. And then we can actually preview the data. Take off 10 for each println. I will not be running the count. First run this. And then you can say copy paste take off 10 for each println. And you can see we got product ID as key and other information as value. Same is the case with products. Now we can safely join these two data sets. Okay. So now we can say val daily revenue per product equal to let's say join daily revenue per product join equal to daily revenue per product ID map dot join products map. Copy this, go here and paste. Okay. And now if you want, you can preview the data by saying dot take off 10 dot for each println and hit enter. And you can see you got the product ID, you got the order date and revenue, and you got the product name. Okay, so did we get the data in as per our requirement? Not yet. Okay, we got all the information that is required, but it is not in the format we need. The format has to be, data has to be sorted in ascending order by date, descending order by revenue. And also data has to be comma delimited, and the first field has to be date, second field has to be revenue, and the third field has to be product name. Okay. And for that, we have to do additional processing, and we will see that as part of the next topic. So far, we joined order items after filtering for completed as well as closed orders. And then we aggregated to get the daily revenue per product ID. And using that, we also joined with products after reading from the local file system and converting into RDD. And now we are in a situation where we got all the information that is required for our problem statement, which are nothing but order date, order revenue, as well as product name. But the output is not sorted yet. And also it is not represented the way we want to save into the file system. And we will see that as part of the next topic.